Okay, how are we doing out there? First things first, my name is Kenneth Bird. I'm the creator of LUMINOUS 4K screen paint using ambient light rejection technology gain times 7 and 8. I like doing these live demonstrations, man. These live demonstrations gives me a chance to show you. I do a lot on Facebook either way, but this is the first ones I started doing on YouTube, and it gives you a chance to see exactly our technology in live. So, you know, we're going to debunk a lot of those crazy rumors that were started about people saying, hey, the screen comes up too dark and so on, so on, so on, so. And we're going to do a lot of live demonstrations, especially some painting ones, too, on top of that. So I actually posted one yesterday of me walking back and forth on my deck inside the house using an ultra short throw projector, doing all the things that you're not supposed to do with this technology. So I decided this is the screen I had outside that I had painted. Doing an outside demonstration, I decided to bring it inside because it is cold as I don't know what outside. So decided to come inside and do a demonstration here. Now I'm gonna walk in front of the projector really quick so you can see what you're looking at. So this is a screen that was partially coated. One half of it was a light gray screen paint. The other half is white, and in the middle we have our Supreme 8 ambient light rejection screen paint, just to show you exactly why contrast is everything and why a light gray screen or a white screen will never ever give you your projector's best performance. Keep in mind, this is my I own two of these projectors. These projectors are amazing. This is my Sony VPL FH30. This projector is 4300 lumens at 1920 by 1200, and it's a WXGA projector. It has about all the bells and whistles on it. It's got the lens shift capability and all of the other cool stuff. So pretty cool projector. So the reason why I'm using such a high powered projector is just to show you that some people think, you know, if I upgrade, if I get myself a projector with more lumens, more capabilities, with more resolution, I'm going to be able to make up for the picture loss that I'm going to lose from a screen that may be light gray or white. The bottom line, it's not your projector. I've been saying this over and over again. It's not your projector. 4,300 lumen projector cannot pull up contrast on a white and gray screen. That just tells you right there, it's not your projector, it's your screen. And I've done business with churches where churches are going out and they've had 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 lumen projectors at 30 feet back, and they're nailing a white screen and they can't figure out why the image is not coming up. And they go out and they buy a more expensive projector because they think, okay, maybe if we jump the lumens and we go 10,000 lumens, maybe we'll be able to see the screen. And then they go into with the contrast ratio, which means they're going to saying, okay, maybe if we get a projector that has 10,000 to 1 or 20,000 to 1 or 50,000 to 1 in contrast, but it doesn't make a difference how high you go in the contrast. Your screen can't pick up contrast, period. So it's not the projector's fault, it's your screen's fault. And here you are seeing it, fully lit environment, as we do our demonstrations in well-lit environments. And I could walk around this screen, and you will see that our technology is the only one picking up an image on 4,300 lumens. This is how close the projector sits. So keep in mind, if a 4,300 lumen Sony projector cannot pull up an image on a white or gray screen, what do you think your projector is doing on a white and gray screen? That's why you have to be in the dark, because the only way that image is going to be able to pull up is going to have to be in the dark. You can't be in a fully lit environment with a white or gray screen. They don't pull up. Remember I told you that a white screen is not that far off from a white wall? There you go, right there. See that? It's not much of a difference. You buy a white screen and say, oh, it's got a 2.0 gain or a 1.1 gain. That's a bunch of bull crap. No, your white screen is the equivalent to a white wall or a white sheet of paper or a white bed sheet. And a gray screen isn't that much of a difference. A light gray screen, the only thing a light gray screen is going to do when it comes against a white screen, it's going to give you a little bit of slight difference when it comes to contrast because it's slightly darker. That's why. Now, also, too, for those of you who are saying, well, you know, I can just get a black piece of material or black paint. Well, that's what this demonstration was for. That is the color of our technology, and that's black. As I said, our technology has a different shade of black. Black comes in multiple forms of shade. But not only that, our technology has something embedded to it actually to pull white levels. If you're curious about that demonstration, and like I said, I have a video to back up just about everything, I will basically put that in the comments section. You can check out the video that was done right here showing a demonstration that's doing white snow scenes and white scenery, just showing you exactly our screen picks up white levels, and white levels is are very important when it comes to a black screen. So let's try it upstairs because we don't have ambient light controlled environments in here. We just have it on and on, switch on and switch off. That's it. Look at that from there. So let's take our lights out, because I'm not going to go into, this is the detail of the screen. I'm not going to go into detail. I'm going to show you true facts on what you're really getting. So we take the lights out, right? Let's see what we get. Now you see the image pulls better when the lights are out. Look at the white screen and look at the white wall. I told you, doesn't make a difference. A white screen will match a white wall. If you go and you buy a white screen, I hate to say it, it's a foolish mistake. Just do it against your wall. Now, if you look at this, get my camera adjusted a little better here. For some reason, there I go. Can't get the zoom back in. Here we are, lights out. The only way that image is going to pull up is you're going to have to be in the dark in order for your screen to pull up. That's why a lot of the demonstrations that you see using light gray screens and white screen paints, the problem you have with that, they have no form of ambient light rejection and they have no contrast. And with the lights out, with very little light in the environment, the image doesn't pull up so well, does it? So let's go back upstairs and let's turn our lights on. Some people don't like to see this because it backs up everything I say or said when I was talking about why white screens and gray, why you'll never see a screen paint that's white or light gray do a demonstration in this kind of environment, this kind of light, because they wash out. Now let's see, let's grab our phone for a minute because a couple videos I got loaded up here. Okay, I got orders to take out today, a lot to do today. Now, this is an OLED demonstration. As I said in my last video, any video demonstration that's OLED, the backgrounds are automatically black. How are you going to produce an image on a light gray screen or a white screen if the image on an OLED video is black? The reason why it's designed to have that much contrast in that video, because OLEDs are black. So when someone does a demonstration using OLED demonstrations, I guarantee you the environment is going to be dark. It has to be. Or you're going to get some kind of ashy gray image. As in ashy gray, let's show you the Starfield demonstration. Now, we all know what color the night sky is. When you go to a planetarium, it's black. It's not gray, it's black. I think today I'm gonna bring down my Optima GT5500. That projector has a 20,000:1 contrast. We're gonna do that live. We're gonna stick my projector right there at 20,000:1. It's gonna sit less than an inch away from the screen at 3,600 lumens. And I'm going to do a star field demonstration, and you will see live why a gray screen or a white screen at 20,000 lumens, a 20,000:1 contrast, can't pull a black level. Now, let's go upstairs because you're not going to be able to see the screen at all because the lights are on. And let's knock our lights out. This is the workout for me, I'm telling you right now. I have no switches downstairs. I don't know why I didn't put no switches downstairs in the basement, but you know, whatever, each his own. And that gives me a workout when I get up in the morning. All right, so we have a little bit of light coming into the window in the background, so. But still. Let's just show you that you're not getting contrast from your screen. All right. So let's pop back upstairs. Turn my lights back on again. I think it's the last time I'm doing this one. I think I proved my point enough. I've had people say, hey, maybe he's changing the camera settings. What is this live? Can't change the camera settings. Let's go with the OLED demonstration. There's another demonstration that is designed to be done on a black surface. Any LGs or anything using OLED technology, any demonstration like that are designed to be used on a black surface, not gray or white. If that was the case, OLED TVs would be gray. The two, LCD would be gray or white. I think I've never seen a white freaking screen before. That'd be kind of weird, a white TV screen. Interesting to look at, but that'd be weird. Check out the fish. And these live demonstrations are posted all over our website. All over Facebook, Twitter, just about everywhere. I like doing the live demonstrations. So live demonstrations just show exactly what you're getting in real time. Let's go get some more fish. Some more deeper blues. What about some bright, beautiful colors? How about that? We already know the screen has the ability to produce contrast. What about bright, beautiful colors? Now, if you notice, I'm gonna go back right here just about a minute. See what I mean by detail is everything. So you see how the detail here on the light gray screen, people think it's brighter. It's not brighter. You're getting a washed out image. So there's no detail in that area. It's detail all around the flower right here. Thank you. So in this demonstration, the background is black. See what I'm getting at? The background is black in the demonstration. Can't see that because these two screens can't pull the background. But yet, keep in mind that on a black screen, the image is supposed to be so dirty that you can't see nothing at all. You can't make out the picture. That's why it's important that when you make a black screen paint, you have to be to produce high white levels, because with high white levels, you can produce a brighter image. Let's go pop over to one other thing. And then after that, I'm done for the day because I have a few more videos to shoot. I thought I would do this one live. For you football fans out there. And look at the white screen paint. This is white screen paint that I got from Amazon. Someone actually sells white screen paint. It's supposed to be like a 3.0 white screen paint. So that right there is painted with 3.0 white screen paint. Look at the side of the wall. Should I expand the screen for you? Let me see if we can expand the screen. Where is my expansion button? There we go. Let's expand the screen. There you go. Go back to the Jazz. I didn't play it all the way through. So I'm gonna like this this demo. There's your white wall. Like I said, a light gray screen, not too far off from a white wall. That's it. Well, interesting, isn't it, that a light gray screen isn't that far off from a white wall. Look at that. So instead of you going out and buying a white screen, just put it on your wall. Save yourself some money. If you're going to go to Root and get a white screen, don't even bother. Just go put it on your wall. There's no difference in that and basically a white wall. They're all the same. So I know people have spent, what, $400, $300 for a white fixed frame Elite screen. You could have just shot that on your wall and been done with it because there's no difference in the screen whatsoever. They'll tell you there's a difference and you think there's a difference, but there isn't. That's just like if you look at we do make a dark gray screen paint. You take a dark gray screen paint. We have one called titanium black silver. Now, titanium black silver produces higher white levels, but contrast, it will never come close to a black screen. I designed it, and I can tell you that hands down. It'll never come close to a black screen. But if I were to take out all the lights in the environment and put on that dark screen paint, you would swear you was looking at black. You're not looking at black. You're actually looking at gray. You wouldn't see the black until a black screen actually laid against it. Then you would see what a black screen looks like, what a true night sky looks like. So that's the same kind of scenario you go with the white screen. White screen is just the same as a white wall, white bed sheet, or a white piece of paper. It's the same thing. You're just paying for it, that's all. Now, I'm not going to come on my videos and tell you, look at the detail, look at the color. We're not going to be sitting in dark and dark environments or have all the lights out in pitch black darkness. No, I put my demonstrations through freaking hell. Excuse my French, Lord, but yes, I put them through some crap. I do demonstrations outside. People don't do that. I do paint on demonstrations outside. People don't do that. Demonstrations that I put my stuff through, no one else does. There's no point in me coming on here and using a 4K projector and saying, hey, look at the detail. The detail is automatically going to be a given on any surface that you use when you're using 4K because it has a higher res count. It's just given. That's like if I do a demonstration on a black screen and I'm doing contrast demonstrations only, it's a given that that black screen is going to produce a higher contrast than a white or gray screen. That's why I do the brighter, more beautiful, vivid colors to show that the black screen can pull higher white levels to be able to come close to either matching or matching or probably coming close to a lighter screen. There's no point in me doing dark contrast because I know the black screen is going to have a higher vantage point. But like I said, you have to put everything out there. If you're afraid and you're light dodging, and I see a lot of people doing demonstrations on their screen paint, they will light dodge. They'll stick a screen in the middle where there'll be no light hitting here and no light hitting here, and they'll have a little bit of light over the top. Or they'll have it set up where they'll have the screen on a slant where the projector's hitting it, but the light is hitting the side of it. And one of my favorite demonstrations I love when people do is they'll take a screen and they'll sit it into a wall. The wall will be like a pocket. They'll sit it into the wall. They'll put a light here, a window here. If you know anything about the physics of light, if you stick a screen inside of a little pocket area and when light travels, it's not going to hit the screen. It bypasses the screen. Screen has to be in direct line of light. That's why we do demonstrations outside, because there is no way to hide a screen from ambient light. Virtually impossible. Even if people say, well, it's a cloudy day, even with a cloudy day, there's more ambient light outside than there is inside your home. That's why we do demonstrations outside, because we can't hide from ambient light. There's no way to get around it. There's no way to use any form of ambient light controlled environment to make the screen look good. And that's what ambient light controlled environments are. It's basically an environment that's set up to accommodate the screen to make it look amazing. So they'll have lights peppered out. You got to watch these videos. Look at these videos very carefully because they'll keep your focus on the screen. You have to look at the surrounding area where the screen is sitting. That's how you know if a screen is ambient light rejection or not. It's the first thing I see when I watch videos. I don't focus on the screen. I focus on the environment because they'll have a light here and a light here and a light here and light here, but there'll be nothing hitting the screen. And you look at it and you go, wow, look at all the lighting in the room. That's ambient light rejection. No, it ain't. Because if I stick that screen outside, that screen will fade just like that. If I put a bunch of lights around that screen, it'll fade. It's not ambient light rejection. We got ridiculed at one point for using 720p projectors. We had screens that looked amazing on 720p. When everybody else was using 4K, when everybody else was using 1080p projectors, we're using 720p projector. That just tells the consumer you don't have to spend a lot of money for a projector. This is the way, if you're going to be replacing common sense, simple common sense, if you're watching a demonstration and it's sitting in the dark. Now keep in mind, if it's in a dedicated home theater room, okay, that's a given. It's a dedicated home theater room. They're designed to be sitting in the dark. That's what they're designed for. But if you're watching a demonstration of someone doing a video in their living room, and that living room is dark, darker than your living room, then guess what? That's where you're going to be sitting at with that projector. In that dark environment, because you're not seeing anything brighter anymore. More now upstairs, my living room, it's extremely bright. That's why we do demonstrations with all the lights on. And every house I've moved to, all the lights are on, plenty of light hitting the screen. Because I have to show my customers, hey, look, if you're going to replace your TV and spend the money for a screen and a projector and set all this up, you don't want to be sitting in the dark. Yeah, think about that. When you come home, you turn your TV on, do you run around the house adjusting all the lights in your environment to accommodate your TV? Do you sit there and say, oh, to open up the window, I don't want you to wash out the TV. Don't turn the lights on, I want you to wash out the TV. Your TV's sitting in a fully lit environment. So why can't your projection screen sit in a fully lit environment? Now, for those of you saying, well, it's a 4,300 lumen projector, that's why you can do that. Well, guess what? Next demonstration, we're going to come over here, and I got quite a few projectors over here to play with. This is my Sony oldest projector I have here. This projector is very old. It's a $45 projector, 1,100 lumen projector, 720p, so old that the projector only does 4.3. That's an old projector, and I think it was manufactured in 1999. It's so old, I can't even pick up anything on it. I found one particular model, but it's a newer model than this one. This is about as old as they get when it comes to projecting. It's old. I'm gonna show you the back of this. I'm gonna see how old this projector is. That's it. The high points on this projector is VGA, S video jack, and audio components. It's that old. This is 1100 lumens. We're gonna take this 1100 lumen projector, we're gonna stick it in the same environment. We're gonna pull it all the way back, and you can see at 1100 lumens that the image is still gonna pull up, and it's still gonna look amazing at 1100 lumens. So we're gonna debunk all, I'm gonna show you all that. We're gonna take the Optima GT 5500 with a 20,000 to 1 contrast. We're gonna pull this up, put it right against the, in front of you, see it? Right against the light gray screen, the white screen, and our technology, and we're gonna do a star field demonstration at 20,000 to 1 contrast. For those of you that are buying projectors, they're thinking, gee whiz, if I get a white screen or a light gray screen, I'm gonna be able to get all that contrast. You're not getting any of it. You're gonna pay for something on that projector that you're not gonna get anything of. You think that ViewSonic is gonna give you a 20,000 to 1 option on your projector for free? No, you paid for that. So you're not gonna get it. And this is to show you at 4,300 lumens, as powerful as this projector is, with the contrast loss. I think this projector has a 800 to 1 contrast. Yeah, 800 to 1 contrast. So we got plenty of toys over here to play with, to do some demonstrations on this particular surface. I've already done this outside, so I will do another live demonstration outside. Let's see if we got anything else here to play with. Going down the road right there. But it just gets you something to think about, because when I have customers call me up and they ask me about screen paint, the first thing they talk about the size of the screen, what kind of projector they have, and next thing they say, hey, look, I have a lot of ambient light in my environment. I want to be able to use the screen in a fully lit environment. I've seen your demonstrations, of course. We're showing you a screen outside at 4 o'clock in the evening producing an image at 21 feet back on a 180-inch screen. Now, really quick, what some people don't realize, and maybe some of you do already, that if you have a projector of 4,300 lumens, if you have a projector of 2,500 lumens, if you have a projector of 2,600 lumens, depending on how much light you have in the environment, you do not have 2,600 lumens by the time it makes destination to the screen. The reason why companies use projectors of 10,000 lumens and 20,000 lumens is because if that projector is sitting back 30 feet, and depending on how much ambient light is in the environment, your lumens are going to start to drop before it hits the screen. So imagine how much light. The more light you have in the environment, white walls generate tons of light. Anything that's bright in the area generates tons of light. Even with the lights out, white walls and all this generate more light. All right, they kill more lumens faster. So that's why if you look at dedicated theater setups, they're not done in all white. They're done in the darkest color possible. So that way they kill as much ambient light in the environment. You understand? Even with the lights out, you are still generating light in that environment. So you're reflecting light. So anyway, that's why a lot of big events have massive high power projectors, because if they start off with 20,000 lumens, they want to make sure by the time that image leaves the projector and makes destination to the screen, they're not going to have 20,000. They may lose 10,000 lumens just making it from A to B. The screen has to generate a high enough gain to be to produce a bright enough image so it can reflect an image back at you so you can see the image crystal clear. Kind of get what I'm saying here? All right, so when you use a projector of 1100 lumens, that means you don't have 1100 lumens by the time you make destination to the screen. You have less than that. That's what some people don't explain to you in the video. Doesn't make a difference on what projector you're using. That's why people go with a higher lumen count. The higher the lumen count, the less lumens you're going to lose. The reason why I do demonstrations in the dark, because that's the less lumens you're going to lose by the time it makes destination to the screen. It's less lumens for the projector to fight with. So instead of you, if the lights are being out, you have a higher chance of showing a better image because you will lose less lumens. Lights on, you will lose more lumens, and you have a greater chance of your image actually diminishing. Like that. Now, theory proved. That's why the picture gets a little better when you turn out the lights, because there's less lumens for the projector, actually less light for the projector to contend with. But when you watch demonstrations, they don't explain it to you. They just say, hey, look how amazing the screen looks. Look at the detail. See it now? So the image doesn't look so faded, does it? That's because there's less light for the projector to fight with. So if I'm using 4,300 lumens and that picture looked faded from this distance, how many lumens dropped off that projector before it made contact with the screen? That's the kind of stuff that goes through my head you got to think about. Can't just take a screen paint, splash it on the wall and say, hey, look, ta-da, screen paint. No. There's calculations, there's measurement of light, all that goes into it. So 4,300 lumens, that's traveling probably about, we're probably about 9 feet from the screen. It's traveling, it makes contact with the screen. There's less light to deal with. The image comes up brighter and comes up better, right? But still, you don't have contrast. And you need contrast to get detail. See the detail in his jacket? And look how it fades here. You're not getting a brighter image, you're getting a washed out image. Now, we'll turn the lights on and we'll give the projector something to fight for. Now, this is inside. We do demonstrations outside. So imagine how many lumens the projector is dropping off before it makes contact with our screen. There you go. It's got a harder fight. Now, if we add contrast into the mix, the star field. Oh, we got a commercial in there. Booyah. It's even better. All right, let's get to our star field. Now, for those of you that are using dedicated home theater setups, and you're saying it doesn't make a difference because I'm sitting in the dark, and I don't have to worry about my picture quality fading or washing out. You don't have to worry about that because you're in the dark, but you do have to worry about the fact that are you getting a true contrast level. So maybe the blacks that you have in Batman or Underworld or anything involving dark contrast, you're not getting what you think you're getting. Because I've seen people on ABS forms go, well, look, I got this 10,000, 12,000 lumen, I'm sorry, 12,000 to 1 contrast on my projector. Big deal. Let me see your screen. I see the screen, it's white or light gray. And the lights are out. And he thinks he's really seeing a black image on his screen. You're not seeing a black image, you're seeing a gray image. Now I show him a demonstration of a screen that's gray, same color as his, white, with a black technology in the middle, and a pitch black room, and I'll turn on that projector of 20,000 to 1, and my contrast is higher than his, and says, look, see the screen? Can't pull contrast, even with the lights out. You're not looking at a black screen, you're looking at a gray screen. This is why you will never see a demonstration being done with star field demonstration. And I'll tell you why. I've seen some people try to do it. When they try to do it, the image comes up like this. Now, let me make a trot back upstairs again. I get a workout on these stairs, I do. Oh man, the Stairmaster 4000. Stairmaster 4000, available on our website for a little price of $19.99 for 3 easy payments. Get your credit cards ready. Here's how to order. All right, here we go. Let's see, because I've got big windows behind me. But even with the lights out, we have 4,300 lumens. 4,300 lumens. Where's the contrast?
She should be able to see something. She did not.
Now, the reason why I do this particular demonstration with bright, beautiful colors. You see the difference here? Let's look at the green cactus here. See how you get a more richer, more beautiful color? But this color will start to fade when you hit a light gray screen or white screen. Like I said, contrast makes color pop. It does. Look at this. Color pop. See how faded and washed that looks there? You need contrast for detail. Have to have detail. Without detail, you don't have depth to your picture. You have to have contrast. Now, you see right here? Look at the white screen. Where is the detail? There's no detail in the flower. There's no ridges, no creases, nothing. Look at the black screen. This is with the lights off. Let's go to a underwater exhibit. Let me see. I'll pull up an underwater exhibit here. Here we go. The ocean is supposed to be a deep, dark blue. See that? Not this. See the detail in the rock here? Well, part of the ocean right there. You see the detail there? It starts to fade off here and here. So, if the only way you're going to be able to see this image is in this dark environment, pretty much that's your living room right there. That's where you're going to be sitting at when you buy a lighter screen paints and white screen paints. You're going to be sitting right over there in the dark. Because your screen can't pull an image out with the lights on. And this is just a little bit of light. This is not a lot of light in the environment. This is just a little bit of light. All right. Hope we enjoyed the video demonstration. I'd like to thank you all for your time. I have to get out of here. If you're interested in getting a better screen, better quality, you can check us out on our website. I'll put all that information at the bottom once I get done editing and adding our information to the page. Let's see, got any other demonstrations? Oh yeah, so this demonstration also that was done showing that our screen produces higher white levels. I'm actually going to post at the bottom. Please check that out. We did all white snowstorms, all different kinds of white images, just to show you how bright our screens can pull images. And those for those people that are saying, well, you're not going to just get black paint. Or I can just get a black sheet. And this right here is actually a black projection screen that I got off Amazon. I bought this off Amazon. It's supposed to be a blackout cloth, or kind of not black, but like a black projection screen material for designing black screens. So I bought this for about $60 off of eBay. I laid half of it here, and Amazon. I laid half of it here, and I put our technology here, and I did a demonstration on white snowstorms and everything white, just to show you that you have to, even though if you have a black screen, you have to have more than black contrast. I did the star field demonstration to show you that both images can pull up contrast, but when doing a white scene, this one comes out dirty and gray, this one comes out bright white. So I will post it at the bottom. Check that out for yourself if you need more proof. All right, thank you all for your time. I have to go, and God bless.